Hello, welcome to Expo Today Live. We have Greg Wood with Deutsche Bank. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, John.
So Greg, you're on two panels, automated trading and self-trade. A lot of confusion. So what on self-trade? What does the industry understand what a self-trade is, regulators?
Well, this is definitely something that we've been trying to help the regulators understand. You know, self-trades aren't desirable, but it's a component now of trading, simply because as the markets are more electronic, they're more automated, as particularly firms, pension funds, asset managers, hedge funds, etc., who may be trading on the opposite side of the trades for various different strategies, they are likely to match in the marketplace. And a self-trade, it's very important to make clear, can occur without intent, so it's not a wash trade. Now obviously when people are looking to trade with themselves with intent, and that is a wash trade, then that is obviously manipulative activity.
What type of technologies are out there to manage this sort of activity in the market?
So definitely in the last 5 years, since we've been surveying exchanges through the FIA, we have seen a big uptake in technology from the exchanges themselves to put tools in place that will prevent self-matches. There's been some differences in implementation between different marketplaces. Some have been more suitable for one type of market participant than another market type participant. But definitely there's been an evolution. We'd like to see that evolution continue.
And how is that process working? Is there sort of a collaborative effort with the industry on that? Or?
Definitely. Through the FIA Market Technology Division and the FIA Principal Traders Group, we've been working very closely with the exchanges to discuss the functionality they're proposing, to make sure that it's suitable for the different types of participants, and you know, to help it evolve.
So on automated trading, a bigger category, we have the SEC looking at market structure. What are the biggest concerns right now?
I think some of the biggest concerns are still helping the regulators understand how the markets have become more automated. The breadth of use of automated trading within the futures markets in particular. It's not just a certain type of participant, but there are also, as I say, asset managers, hedge funds, CTAs, pension funds now, who are using automated trading tools to conduct their interaction with the market. And helping, you know, so our job really at the FIA is to help the regulators understand how this has been evolving across the marketplace, different types of participants, and what that then means to the marketplaces and the sort of controls that need to be around how automated systems are deployed in the market.
What's next with the SEC on the automated trading? Have they finalized the rules at this point?
Or? With the SEC or the CFTC?
CFTC, actually.
CFTC,
yeah.
We're expecting some rules to come out at the end of the year from the CFTC. This has been actually a very long iterative process from the CFTC. They published a concept release back in 2013. The FIA provided an 80-page response to that. We've also then distilled some of that into a best practices paper around automated trading system development and controls, which we'll be talking about on the panel. We're now ready then, you know, we've had conversations with the regulators about these rules coming up. We're now ready to then leverage some of the work that we've done to provide feedback to the CFTC when they actually propose their regulations.
How would you, has it been a pretty collaborative process? I mean, in terms, the concept release was a couple of years ago, and we're here now, 2 years later. Do you get the sense that there was sort of a good flow of information back and forth?
Oh, absolutely. So the concept release, yeah, sparked off a lot of conversations between different types of trading firms, different participants in the market, including the exchanges themselves. We've collaborated on taking some of the ideas that were in the concept release and then putting them into this best practices paper that we'll talk about on Thursday. But we've also then had discussions with the regulators off of that. So I think it's been a very good collaborative process, and I think this is where we in the industry, you know, like to work with the regulators so that they understand the challenges and can approach the challenges in a way that is obviously structured and appropriate to the marketplace and reflects how the marketplace has evolved over the last few years, particularly with regards to the increase of automated trading.
Well, Greg, a lot of work over the last few years and more to come. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Joanne.
Thanks. Stay tuned for more on Expo Today Live.